satisfy the inverse of the Laplace transform of e to the negative 2s over s where times s minus 1. So, first looking at this, we see that there's a lot of things here. So I'm going to rewrite it in some way. So let's bring the e to the negative 2s down here and rewrite the rest. Okay. Now for this one, we are going to use partial fraction decomposition method to rewrite it in fraction forms. But I'm lazy and I don't want to work with the dot law method, so I'm going to use a shortcut here. And the shortcut says we need to, by the way, I also need to factor out 1 over s in order to use a shortcut. Why? Because the shortcut says we need to have the same degree of s. So if s has to be s and s, if s squared has to be s squared and s squared. Okay? So if you haven't had a chance to, if you don't know what I'm talking about, please go up here to watch the video that I made about finding the Laplace, finding the partial fraction decomposition in less than 30 seconds. It will help you understand this in that what I came up when solving partial fraction is pretty much easy in the fastest way, I believe, to find partial fraction. After watching that video, if you're not comfortable using it, you can use the long method or your own method that you have learned. It's okay, but the goal is to find the partial fraction, and this is what I refer to when solving the problem. So we need, after I factored out 1 over s, I have 1 over s times s plus minus 1. And that, let me add a step here. Let me factor out 1 over s, and I have 1 over s times s minus 1 times e to the negative 2s, right? This, and 1 over s times s minus 1. I have something over s plus something over s minus 1. That's for sure. Of course, multiply by e to the negative 2s at the end. Okay, when you notice, this and this, they are off by 1, so I'm going to have 1 on top, and the next step is to determine which one has a negative sign. So which one, as I experienced, the smaller one will, the bigger one will carry out the negative sign. So this is a bigger one, so it's going to have the negative sign, and let's check it. Negative 1 times s, negative s, plus s, 0. Negative 1 times negative 1, positive 1, which is what we have here. Okay, good. Now, distribute this out. Then I have negative 1 over s squared plus 1 over s times s minus 1, and all of these multiply by e to the negative 2s. Again, you have 1 over s times s minus 1, right? So we already did it down here. Okay, so this is the same as this, and we have this again. So basically, you just plug this into here. Okay? So very quickly, you can find its partial fraction. Now let's see, I have negative 1 over s squared plus negative 1 over s plus 1 over s minus 1, all multiplied by e to the negative 2s. Okay, now I'm going to work this out first because that's the most obvious one. So I would have u of t minus 2. Now I'm done with that. Now back to whatever inside of parentheses. L inverse of 1 over s minus squared is going to be negative t, okay, minus 1. Oh, by the way, so this t has to match up with this t over here, so it has to be t minus 2. Oh, I missed that. Minus 1, because 1 over s is just 1. Plus 1 over s minus 1, we have e to the negative, or we have e to the positive t. And the t had to match up with this t over here, so eventually it turns out t minus 2. Okay? So, let me clean this up. Oh, I left a lot of space here. Let me move it over here. So, let's get rid of this. Okay, you can simplify this as multiply this out and then combine like terms. So, I would have, I ran out of space here. So, I have negative t minus negative 2, which is positive 2, minus 1, plus 1, plus e to the t minus 2, times u of t minus 2. That should be your final solution. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.